Consider the following expressions. False, Q, true, P or Q, not Q or P. The number of expressions given above that are logically implied by P and P implies Q is, we need to find out the number of expressions which are logically implied by P and P implies Q. Now, what is the meaning of logical implication? Let's try to understand that first. If suppose we say P logically imply Q, what does it really mean? P logically imply Q simply means that P implies Q is a tautology. Simple. Or we can also say valid. When we say P logically implies Q, this simply means that P implies Q is a tautology. If you remember about the logical equivalence, when we say P is logically equivalent to Q, then it simply means that P by conditional operator Q is a tautology or valid, right? This is something we already learned in the previous lectures. Here we need to find out the number of expressions which are logically implied by this expression. Let's try to minimize this expression P and P implies Q. P and P implies Q. This can be minimized further as this is equivalent to P and P naught or Q, right? P and P naught or Q. Instead of P implies Q, I'm replacing this expression with P naught plus Q. We can apply distributive property here. This is equivalent to P and P naught or P and Q. P and P naught is false, right? And this is PQ. False or with PQ is PQ. So we can say that P and P implies Q is logically equivalent to PQ, right? Now let's see how many expressions are logically implied by this particular expression. Let's consider the first expression. PQ logically implies false. Now if PQ logically implies false, then this has to be a tautology. Let's try to make this expression false. If we are succeeded in making this expression false, then definitely it is not a tautology. And hence we can say that PQ does not logically implies false, right? Now as this expression is false, if we make this expression true, then true implies false is false. And hence we can say that PQ does not logically implies false. We can make this expression true by taking P true and Q true. Then this whole expression becomes true and true implies false is false. And hence we can say that expression 1 is not logically implied by P and P implies Q, right? Let's consider the second expression. PQ logically implies Q. Let's try to make this expression false. In order to make this expression true, we need to take P true and Q true. Now if Q is true, here also Q is true. This is true implies true. Hence we can say that this whole expression is true, right? We cannot make this expression false. And hence Q is logically implied by P and P implies Q. Now let's consider the third expression. PQ logically implies true. Now we already know that if right hand side of implication is true, then we won't be able to make this expression false anyhow. Hence we can say that this expression is also a tautology, right? So this is also correct. Now let's consider the fourth expression. PQ logically implies P or Q. We need to take P true and Q true so that this expression becomes true. Now if P is true and Q is true, here also P is true and Q is true. True OR with true is always true, right? And true implies true is also true. Hence we can say that this expression is also logically implied by P and P implies Q. Now the last expression. PQ logically implies Q naught or P. Let's try to make this expression false by taking P true and Q true. If P is true, we already know that true OR with anything is always true, right? And hence we can say that this whole expression is also valid expression. Again, P and P implies Q logically implies not Q or P. So, how many expressions are there which are logically implied by P and P implies Q? There are four expressions which are logically implied by P and P implies Q. Hence, we can say that the answer of this question is 4.